You're supposed to bow or shake someone's hand. It's not about that discourse. It's more about knowing more about yourself and your own culture. So it'll be interesting because I know we have a mix in here between some international students and then the Indian students yourselves are so diverse. There's so much diversity in your country that it's United Nations of India. So I think... So that's interesting. So we'll be looking at that diversity too, because a lot of times we say India, but what is India? It's everything and then it's opposite, right? So that would be quite interesting for us who are non-Indians to be exploring with you, the experts, the native informants, right? So we'll look at that some more, because really the goal is not know about all cultures I'll work with, but know much more about my own. And the more I can identify specificities of myself and my own culture, my own biases, my own received ideas, prejudices perhaps, the better I can deal with different cultures. So it's really a journey into self-knowledge. Alright, so that's where we're going. So I'll just introduce myself really quickly, and then we'll look a little bit at what we're doing. So you will be getting my slides in the form of perhaps a photocopy for 3 per page or something, so you'll have those. You'll also be getting the course outline. So I'll share the course outline of how we're going to divide the assignments, right? So my name is Michelle Neely, and I'm here from France. So I live in France, but I am not French. Yeah. So, in the true intercultural spirit, I'm coming from France, but I'm not from France. I live there. My name lives French, but it's because my great-great-grandfather immigrated to where? Where do you guys think I'm from?
Canada,
U.S. Yeah, I'm a Yank, as they call me in England, right? So I'm actually even worse than that. I'm from Texas. Oh, no. I can talk about that one as well. But I'll try to see it. I'll watch my accent. It's hard. Once in a while it happens because I can't say you all. I say y'all. So y'all, we're going to have fun. Okay. So the idea then is that I'm going to work with you because I'm also fascinated with India. I'm an anthropologist and I'm kind of a fanatic about Asian cultures, but especially I'm very interested in Indian culture. So I'm passionate about learning more and I've studied quite a bit and read a lot about your traditions. And I see how they inform. I'm trying to look at how traditions inform managerial practice. And so that's what my work as an anthropologist is, trying to see how the traditions still show up. And through this process of globalization, they don't really disappear, they just transform. Right? So we think homogenization is coming and we're going to all become this big Starbucks culture or, you know, McDonaldization of society is happening. I don't think so. I think it's much slower. So I'm going to look at that with you guys and see how is Indian tradition everywhere in unexpected places, right? And how can you capitalize on those strengths of your traditions in management, right? Because you have specificities to bring to international business that are absolutely important to maintain. But we'll look at some of those things. That's my work. And so I'm in Grenoble, Côte d'Ivoire. So I'm in Grenoble, which is in the Alps, very different from here. And with students much like yourselves, students who go on to postgraduate studies after doing engineering or other forms of study, and they're going on and going into either MBA programs or specialized master's programs. And then I also work with doctoral students doing a DBA, which you have now here at the Gandhi Lab. You have the Doctors of Business Administration. So people do go on from the master's after they've had some more work experience and at the executive level, and they do part-time doctorates. So I work with students a lot like yourselves, and a lot of them are in Grenoble because we have a student body that's really mixed. So lots of Indians, but also lots of Chinese and students from Singapore and all over Africa and lots of Middle Easterners. So, plus of course North America and the rest of Europe. So there's a lot of diversity, so I really enjoy this. But I'm happy to see that we have some international students. We're going to do an activity with them. Specifically with them for this course. So maybe just raise your hands. How many international students are in here right now? So can I get a count? 1, 2, okay, hold your hands up high. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So about 12 of you, good. And they're all kind of clustered together, so we're going to mix them in. All right, we'll mix you guys. So it'll be fun. So good, so let's look at this then. What are we going to do in here? So how are we going to grade this large group? We have a very short class. We have today and then the next 3 days. And the final day, we have an exam in the afternoon. So I'm not going to give you the traditional type of exam where you have to memorize by rote and come back and tell me the terms and do multiple choice. We'll do that for a quiz. Do you have a quiz? But the exam will be more on being able to take the knowledge and apply it to the terms, because that's really what's interesting is. I'm happy if you know the terms, because the terms will be useful to you, because when we talk about culture, we often become a little bit emotional in business if someone stereotypes us, or if someone says something that shows their ignorance. We have an emotional defensive response, or offensive response. We're going to try to minimize that, so knowing the terms and knowing it's actually a scientific course of study about culture will help us, as managers, maintain what? If we don't get emotional, we can maintain what? There are different responses for that.
Objectivity.
Objectivity, very good. What else?
Composure.
Composure. A little bit of, yeah, to have more
perspective.
So we need all of that. And it's very hard if we become emotionally attached to what people are saying about us as managers. So we need to keep that distance. So the course will help you with that. But the case will show me, can you take that stuff and apply it in a way which will be, I think, beneficial to the people in your team. Because I think all of you are going for a career as manager. Some of you have already managed. That would be nice for me to hear about who here has actually worked in a more multinational or international environment. Who here has been in an international work environment already? Raise your hands high so I can see. Good. All right. I have a few. And maybe some shy ones. Yes. All right. Good. So we will need your perspective, right? Because we're going to ask a lot of questions where you have a unique experience. Maybe you've worked more with Germans, or you've worked more with, I don't know, Norwegians, or something else, maybe Japanese. So this will be very useful for us. So what have you done? What's happened? What's your experience? Does it actually match what we're saying? So this is what we're going to be doing. So we'll have an exam at the end. We'll have a quiz the day before, which will be more looking at some of the dimensions and the actual names of the models we're working on and trying to understand. And of course, I'm going to be paying attention to who's here. So we will be taking roll. I'll be trying to get to know a few names. It's hard, but I'll try to get there. And you just can say your first name if you have anything to say. Try to remind me of your name, and slowly we'll enter. And then, of course, I'll be paying attention to how you participate, because I have lots of group work. So we'll be doing, for example, some role plays and different things. I'll give you an assignment to do as a group one evening, and then the next day you come in, and we'll see who will be chosen to present. So it won't be everyone, you don't know, right? We do it, we'll pull your name out of a hat, as we say. All right? So, just looking at this, then Albert Einstein, he was a master of simplifying very complex things, right? So everything should be made as simple as possible. But what was the disclaimer? What's the second part of this sentence?
Not one bit simple.
But not that simple, absolutely. And that's exactly what he said, not too simple. So it means that culture, you know, any subject of study can be seen this way. There's a side of it which can be simplified, but there's another side which must be made more complex and seen as something that is different.
Let me just turn it up then.